honors and praises and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior. His name is Yahweh, Hashem, Yahabashai, Bahasham, Wahavaka Kodash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and His Son's name is Yahabashai. And who we reverence and honors to the elder apostles of great millstone that taught me this truth, and those of you that are in the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few, brothers and sisters, listening and learning in the hopes of being saved in your faith. This lesson is going to be called the gift of the Holy Spirit. And that's a gift in itself. What did John say? How can a man receive anything unless it be given unto him? Okay? So the gift of the Holy Spirit is a gift. It was given. And you're going to be what? Spiritually inspired to go out on the highways and byways, to teach, to do this day in, day out. You have to be spiritually inspired. Okay? By Yahweh. Now let's go to 1 Timothy 3:16. Right? All scripture is given by the inspiration of the Most High. So you have to actually be inspired. Okay? And it's Yahweh that inspires his men to continue to have faith. And it's profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. So this is our diet, these words, the precepts. Right? And a lot of our people, they say, well, who wrote that? You know? Who wrote that Bible? It was men that were inspired. It's what the 2 Peter 2:1. Because yeah, you could be inspired on the right hand, and you can be inspired on the left hand. But these men, these prophets, they were inspired on the right hand side. Okay. So let's go to 2 Peter 1:21. Right? 2 Peter 1:21. Let's get straight to it. For the prophecy came not in old time, but by the will of man. Right? So a lot of people are saying, it was men that wrote it. The scripture says, but by not the will of man, but holy men. So it wasn't of the will of man, I'm just going to write this down. Okay? But holy men. Men that were separated from the world. Of the Most High spake as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. So they were moved by the Holy Spirit. You have to be moved to do what we're doing. Okay? So that's what they were moved by. Okay? The Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is a motivator. Okay? It didn't come through the impulse of men. I just want to do this. Man cannot will himself to do anything. Okay? And now we're going to go to... Acts 1:6. When they therefore will come together, they asked him, saying, Lord, you have a shine. And this was the red disciples, will thou at this time restore again the kingdom of Israel? Okay. So the disciples, they were hastening back then. They wanted the kingdom to come back then. And that's the spirit we're supposed to be in. Right? Are you going to restore the kingdom of Israel at this moment? Okay, they wanted that to happen when Yahweh was on the scene, but it was not that time. The then prophecy would not be fulfilled. And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the time or the season. Okay, so if anybody's telling you, it's this time, it's that time, we don't know a time, but we know Yahweh is near. Okay? We're not speaking about 5 years, 4 years. We know he's near. Okay? We've got a lot of men that got caught out. The year 2000 prophecy, which if you were reading the scriptures, you wouldn't even put a date upon it, because the scriptures said, he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times nor seasons, which the Father had put in his own power. That's why you have to read the scriptures. So if anybody's telling you, it's this particular year, fear off, because we don't know, but we have that expectation, okay, that you shall receive power after the Holy Spirit has come upon you. That was a promise. Okay? That was a promise. That was an agreement. And you shall be witnesses unto me received that power. It tells you that in John, those that believed in Yahweh, those that received him, he gave them the power to become the sons of the Most High. Okay? So when it says the Holy Spirit shall come upon you, when did the Holy Spirit come upon his disciples? And disciples, because they were being taught, but it came upon them when they were apostles, when they were sent out, when Yahweh was no longer there with them in the flesh, that he was there for the spirit. Let's go to John 7 and 30. Start at 38, Baruch Hashem. Okay. And 38. And he that believed on me, as the scripture have said. Right? So you have to believe in Yahweh as the scripture have said. Not your own mind, not your own perception. As the scripture have said. Truly, that the true worshippers shall worship Yahweh in truth and in spirit. Out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. And what's that? These words, the Holy Spirit. And the belly goes into what? Seat of thought. The seat of faculty. So out of his mind is going to flow rivers of living water. You're going to be abundant in this trip. You're going to be able to go every single day without stop. New topics, learning new things. This is what the Holy Spirit does. It's a spirit of understanding. It's a spirit of patience. The spirit of what? Tongues. In Corinthians, so like 1 Corinthians 12, it tells you about all the gifts. Tongues, wisdom, faith, healing, distinguishing spirits, which is discernment, miracles, prophecy, knowledge, interpretation. And guess what? Some men have all of that. Why? Because they work on Yahweh Shai. They were working on this truth. Okay, let me stop there. Okay, I'm passionate. See, that's the Holy Spirit. Even when you're passionate, when you're fervent, that's the Holy Spirit. They were given these gifts because they were working on the gift they had. And that's what happens. When you don't work on the gift, you have to takes it away. But where was I? Still in John 7 and 39. But this state, he of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, which they believe on him should receive. So he was saying, those that believe on me, as the scripture has said, they were going to receive the Holy Spirit. And a man that's flowing out what rivers of living water, that's because the Holy Spirit is upon him to do that. Which is what a gift. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given, because Yahweh Shai was still with them. It says that Yahweh Shai was not yet glorified, and that glorification came after what? The crucifixion. That's when the Holy Spirit was given unto you. The disciples related to the apostles. Okay, so they were strong, they were able to what? To stand on their own two. Why? Because they had the Holy Spirit guiding them. Okay? And that's what we're teaching. This is what we're teaching you in the truth. Yes, you're gonna come up underneath men. Then there's gonna be a time if the Spirit is really dealing with you, okay? Because a man could pass away. He's gonna give you what? The right direction. Where to go. Okay? But don't get it twisted. The scripture says you are still under tutors. But there may be something you don't know. Okay? Because you don't know it all. There's still things that Yahweh is going to expand with us in the kingdom. Okay, so you always got to keep that in mind. But yes, the Holy Spirit is given when Yahweh was glorified. Okay? So yes, there's men up on the earth with the Holy Spirit today. Let's go to John 6 and 63. And I could go longer, but I want to just keep this short. Let's go to John 6 and 63. It is the Spirit that quickeneth. Quickened, make it alive. Okay? Refresh, revitalize. Nothing. You see how Yahweh speaking, he says the flesh doesn't profit anything. From the moment you're born, the flesh is decaying. The flesh profits nothing. So none of the flesh profits nothing. We want to do things that pertain to the spirit. Okay? There's no gain from the, you can't really gain from the flesh. You can gain from the spirit, the Holy Spirit. The people of the world, they want the gain in the flesh. But then they don't experience the gain in the spirit. The any spirit, and the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit. These words are the spirit. It's an energy, it's a vibration. And they are life. These words are living. Okay, and the Holy Spirit is what? The Holy Spirit is flowing. Okay? So stay spiritually inspired. Every brother's got a gift. Use that gift and use it to the best of your ability. And if you're using that gift, you have to increase you with what you have. Until the next time, shalom to the hopeful one. Shalom.